थैंक यू ऑर्गेनाइजर्स, थैंक यू स्टार ग्लोबल, थैंक यू चेयरपर्सन, थैंक यू सुनीता मैडम, नंदिता मैडम एंड ऑल स्टार डिग्निटरीज ऑफ हिसार फॉर गिविंग मी अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माय व्यूज ऑन ओबेसिटी एंड इनफर्टिलिटी. दिस इज सम ऑफ माय क्रेडेंशियल्स एंड आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट ऑल रिसर्चर्स टू बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्किड बिकॉज ऑर्किड इज अ 16 डिजिट आधार कार्ड ऑफ योर्स. इट विल गिव यू ऑल एंड ऑल विद इन 116 डिजिट्स. The moment child is born, mother is also born. She is existing. Mother is something new, said by Rajneeshji. With the blessings of mother of mine, three book written by me is recommended in Royal College as a reading material. Atlas of Fetal Echocardiography and Technique of IVF Made Easy, gone for second edition. And I am editor-in-chief of two journals. If we classify obesity, we know it is underweight. Everybody nowadays, obesity is equal to BMI. And today my talk is going to be on class 1 obesity, that is BMI 30 to 34.9, class 2 severe obesity, that is 35 to 33.9, and class 3 obesity or extreme or morbid obesity more than 40. If you see trends, prevalence in obesity in worldwide, USA, England, Luxembourg, Netherlands, from 2008 to 2022, obesity is nearly increasing from 10 BMI to 30 to 35 BMI. So in my presentation, I would outline the presentation in impact of obesity on fertility potential, role of obesity in ART, and weight reduction in obesity. We all obstetrician and gynecologists have to play with these four ECAs, FSH, LH, estrogen and progesterone. These four ECA in our hand and we are playing in each plus or minus, and our normal menstrual cycle also runs on that, and our IVF practices also run on that. If we grade the obesity with irregular menstrual cycle, we know that in grade 1 or 2 obesity, the irregularity is only 19%. But if you see in grade 3 and grade 4, that is more obese person, the irregularity of menstrual cycle is more than 54%. If we compare it with obese with or without menstrual disorder, most important thing is leg fast mat and trunk leg fat ratio. This is utmost important, and if you see it is p value is more than 0.001. So if we see the by age of 33, if she is underweight and if she is obese, you can see that this is study conducted by 1958 by British Quartility Control. It is on more than 7,700 patients. If obese BMI, the value is 2.43. If we see woman with an ovulation, this is study by Hartz in 1979, old study, but it is conducted on more than 26,000 women. And they say is that if she is overweight, chances of an ovulation is 8.6%. If you put all this control, high BMI and low BMI, this is our normal control. The hormonal rearrangement, you are looking at high BMI, high estrogen and high progesterone level. And if you see the LH pulses is also irregular. So if we see by which mechanism she is infertile, increased conservation of androgen to estrogen in adipose tissue, second, decreased gonadotropins, disturbed LH pulsatility, decreased HSPC level by insulin, insulin stimulate increased production of androgen from the ovaries and changes of production to the adipocytes. The adipokines, it is decreased in blood level with primary effect of increase in fat oxidation and increase insulin sensitivity. The effect on insulin sensitivity, it increased. Likewise, registin increased, leptin is also increased. And if we see the effect on estrogen and progesterone on human granular cell, this effect of leptin compared to control is very high. So the risk ratio conceiving within 12 months with obese person, if we compare with normal weight, it is 0.91, like in obese person it is 0.70. So it is too low if they don't receive treatment within 12 months of infertility. If we compare this prevalence of lifetime nulliparity and nulligravity by high school BMI categories of yellow bars, this all are yellow bars are nulligravity and this is nulliparity. This is a Swan study on more than 3154 women. It also says that obesity is detrimental for the infertility. So if we see case control of 2527 with control of 46,000, study conducted by Rich and Edward in 1994, they said that if BMI is from 20 to 32, the relative risk of infertility ranges from 1.2 to 2.7%. If we put all this on this Foster chart, You can say that with increasing body mass index, the increasing obesity ratio, this study was conducted on Nurse Health Study in 2002. They said with increasing BMI, this is a 40 BMI, that the odd ratio for ovulatory infertility is very high. So our second role is role of obesity in heredity. If any patient come to us, our first prime response to start with clomipenem. But we all know that clomipenem in WHO 2 category, if you use with reduction in increasing BMI or reduction with increased hip waist ratio, you can see that ovulation induction will be very low. Sometimes there is a clomipenem resistance, there is no ovulation if there is high BMI. So association between obesity and total amount of FSH use. If you are failed with clomipenem, be forced to use follicle stimulating hormone. And this is in WHO 2 group of ovulation production, study conducted by Mulders in 2003. We see in this poster bar, with increasing obesity, there is increasing dose of 1000 to 1450 units of FSH we have to give for that woman to get good number of ovulation. Same way, same study, you can see all bar are in the form of non-obese person. In obese person, the rate of infertility is very high. If you compare with this IVF ICSI cycle and response to gonadotropin, we know that in obese person, we have to use increased duration of stimulation. We have to give increased amount of gonadotropins, increased cancellation cycle, because Kundanigle has rightly said that with erratic formation of ovulogens or erratic formation of androgens, we don't get good cohort of follicle that we want in infertile patients. A lower number of medium or large size follicle, that is erratic growth of follicle, and decreased number of oocyte retrieved, even we have got so many empty follicles oocytes are there. This is a this is a graph of expected number of oocyte retrieved related to women with body mass index of BMI. This is multilinear regression analysis only included in the first IVF of intracytoplasmic sperm. You see, this according to the age, this is number of oocyte retrieved. And if you see BMI, if BMI is 42, number of oocyte retrieved is less than 10. And that is a longitudinal multicentric cohort study of more than 487 patients with 1467 cycles. It shows that there is negative association of between the number of collected oocyte and BMI. Same way, the expected number of oocyte related to woman mass index in association with BMI, the number of oocyte shows a quadruplic relation with an inverse U-formed curve with fewer oocytes among the obese women. This is number of oocyte retrieves, that if we see if the BMI is 40, oocyte retrieves is only 1 or 2. They are coming in the category of Posidonia. If we compare the live birth rate over the overweight normal women, there are different studies from 2009 to 2010. It says that if BMI is less than 25 and BMI is more than 25, if we see odd ratio, it covers that this is 25 line. If covers that BMI is less than 25, the results of fertility potential or baby coming with normal weight is very good. This is a very busy slide of BMI meta-analysis. Worldwide, they study that BMI is more than 25, BMI is between 25 to more than 25, or 30 to 20, less than 25. Every BMI data or live birth rate suggests that if BMI is less than 25 or equal to 25, live birth baby rate is very good. If we adjust that live birth rate according to the BMI, compared with the fresh IVF cycle of more than 4,609 patients, this study coming in Fertility Sterility Journal 2012, it says that if the BMI is 18.50, odd ratio is coming to one level. But if BMI is 40, then odd ratio is coming between 0.2, 0.1 to 0.3. If you put all this in Foster graph, it says that live birth rate apply IVF for overweight and normal weight according to the age. Live birth weight with normal weight is good, BMI is less than 25, but if it is overweight, chances of getting first baby live born is very less. What are the predictors of first live birth? If we compare all cycle with all fresh cycle in female BMI with female age and male age, if we see in female age, the odd ratio prevalence value is 0.037 with p value of 0.001, and this is important sentence, that for each increase in woman BMI, 1 gram kg per meter square, for each 1 year increase in woman age and men's age. So if she is not obese, she has also increased her age by 1 year, and that is increasingment of 1 year in woman age since it generational age. If suppose woman is 36, for IVF she is 37. But if she is obese, then it becomes 38 year of age. So obesity and IVF probability of live birth, if she is normal weight, probability is very good. So if it is obese, then probability of involuntary cycles is very high. Sir has rightly talked about male, but male has got obesity, and there is evidence to male is it alters sperm function, increases sperm DNA damage, decreases sperm mitochondrial activity, induces seminal oxidative stress, impairs blastocyte formation, and reduces pregnancy outcome in ART, and it also increases miscarriage rate. And this is overall slide with male infertility. If normal weight IVF birth rate is 30.6, but IVF and ICSI with obesity, it goes around very low. This is impact of BMI. This is score age multiplied by BMI. And if you see it is more than 1000, the fertility potential rate is very good. Endometrial gene expression in the window of implantation. Everybody is talking about window implantation. At this particular site, we have to put our embryo inside the uterine cavity with maximum implantation potential point, if we are putting single or double. This study was conducted on 151 gene were dysregulated or transcripted or biosynthesized. Obese with PCOS, dysregulated genes related to development, morphogenesis, and immune system, and they done biopsy on day of LH surge on day plus 7. And what they found, if you use donor oocyte, obese versus normal, if it is obese, if it is normal, then pregnancy rate is very good. Same applies on surrogacy, impact on outcome. If surrogate is obese, fertility potential is very less. Same way with high BMI, single blastocytes, the miscarriage rate is very high. So lastly, weight reduction and infertility. Weight reduction will go for a lifestyle modification, medical treatment, and bariatric surgery. And this is very good lifestyle modification program in women. They have done 6 months of lifestyle modification with 18 months of infertility treatment. And you can see both FSH, LH, and control group and international group, they are very good. And life intervention in obese, they have proved that there is no increase in healthy birth rate, but natural conception has increased. So if we advise our woman to lose weight, it is very good. Last slide of obesity as an important component of metabolic syndrome has a significant adverse impact on male fertility and polycystic ovary. If we see the mechanism of obesity with PCOS, obesity induces ovulatory dysfunction and menstrual irregularity. It induces increase in the androgen production due to higher circulating level of insulin, aromatization of this androgen to estrogen causing negative feedback on hypothalamic pituitary ovary nutrient axis, and impairing gonadotropin production. So documented facts on infertility: spontaneous conception increases to pregnancy with lower pregnancy rate, obesity is associated with increased risk of menstrual irregularity and ovulation. Ovulatory woman with fertility clinic found has got 40% lower pregnancy rate compared to 1 kg per meter square over BMI of 29 kg per meter square. Assisted reproduction decreases rate of fertilization, embryo transfer, and implantation of pregnancy. A very good study of 721 couple undergoing first IVF cycle and found that the relationship between female BMI and clinical pregnancy and low birth rate not statistically significant. They controlled for male and female age, parity, partner BMI. They also noted that female BMI was not related to the fertility potential. High risk miscarriage, sexual function. Lastly, concluded obesity has got negative impact on fertility potential. Obese woman may have menstrual irregularity and lower possibility to conceive even for adolescent. There is reduced response to ovulation inducing agent. Oocyte quality is affected. Endometrial function may be impaired. The role of men's obesity needs for further investigation. Lifestyle modification is recommended, but it is increased natural conception only in ovulatory infertility practice. So at the end, everybody should be happy. If you are radio, so I will arouse somebody. Can you put audio on?
And the place to be happy is here, and the way to be happy is to make someone happy and have a little have a
here. Thank you very much. And the outside, I will urge everybody to give vote to Sunita Tendulkar, our FOCSI president. And thank you, madam. From the beginning, you have given me opportunity to partake and part in thyroid panel. Thank you, James. Thank you very much.
After said that obesity is going to have a negative effect on infertility, but the obese patient, it is very difficult to do the ovum pickup also.
Right. Can I also request Dr. Ladika Agarwala ma'am to please be the co-chair, and I also request Dr. Randhir Singh to please join us on the dais to save time.